really, it is a blessing to be here. I'm so excited. I'm excited about what God is doing. Really, I get excited when I come back here. And I'm able to see how God is blessing here and work here, because God is working here just like He is there and like He is working in other countries. And sometimes, you know, we get so used to the same thing, but you know, you're involved with the lives of these missionaries around the world, and I just thank God for the opportunity to be able to come here. I was talking with John Olson, and I thank God that, and where is he this morning? Where is John Olson? Is he here somewhere? Okay, but he's preparing for his message today. But Trisha, I was talking with Trisha, and they brought a group at one time from their church to Australia in 2005, and we had just started working there. We had just gotten there. We had not. are many Muslim areas. And many missionaries were killed in those Muslim areas. And I can name name after name of Australians that have gone to that area. And the Muslims have killed them. One family, the father, and two boys, actually three boys. They were in their car, and they were coming home from church, and the Muslims had them stop. They stopped their car, and then they killed the father and the boys. And many people in America don't hear that. We hear about ISIS beheading people. We don't hear about these things happening all over the world. They're happening all the time. We get so used to it. But people still go to those countries, still spread their lives, and still go to tell people about Jesus. Well, the Solomon Islands, and this is our sign from Solomon Island. It's the same, it sounds like Solomon, how you sign Solomon. In the Solomon Islands, we have 9 different areas. These areas. Then we also have a Western group up here. Well, one of our missionaries, Tim Meyer, he's been going up to this country since 2000, since year 2000. They had a civil war there at the time. There was a civil war between two of the islands, the one I said, Malaysia, and then another island. And the people are very educated, and they came, and they learned, and they began taking land, and they were like, no, you're not here from your island, you can't come and take land, and start a civil war. But anyway, many of the people, many people in this specific area, but also, it's third world, these are third world countries. Medical missionaries go to these areas to help the medical needs and try to help them medically. And so there's a lot of people with illnesses there. Malaria is a huge illness. People come from other countries to do medical work. And so we just want to give you an idea. We have a plan. We've established a plan. The first step of that plan is to establish a ministry called the Oceanic Baptist Outreach. And just recently, in June, here, we established it. I established it. I came for a meeting here in June. And you say, why? Well, there's so many different countries where the missionaries can't get into a country. They're actually called closed countries. And one of them is China. China does not let missionaries come in. You have to go in to teach English. You cannot say that you are there to preach. And so you go to teach English, and as a result, you're able to witness. But some countries will even limit people that are coming there to 3 months. You can stay for 3 months or 1 year, and then you have to leave. And so that's the Solomon Islands. It's, you're only over there for 3 months. We can go for 3 months, and we got to leave. Back 3 months, we had to go back. We had to go back and forth in that way. Well, since and you notice preparing for this work, we're actually preparing for us on this. Because one day we will, return. Just like that general said, I will return. I have a plan. I will make a plan. And in that strategic time, I'll take one step by step. And I will get back to those islands. We'll return, and we will. We'll win the war. And you know that God has already given us the victory. Amen? Right? We will win. But we need to know that Satan also wants to get a hold of the heart there. And so we've got to witness as much as we can. Well, America needs missionaries. I understand that Patton Hall needs missionaries. There's some needs missionaries, but we're asking that you pray about God burning your heart. Revival begins when you say, Lord, what do you want me to do? And whether it be here, whether it be in Peru, whether it be in Mexico, military, Canada,